Hey everybody, welcome! My name is Layani, and today we're gonna start a brand new playlist, which is a full course from zero to advanced about modern Angular. I've been working with Angular since version 2. I shipped my first product to production using version 4 of Angular, so it's been about almost 10 years, and a lot has changed since 2016. We don't even have to go back that long. We can go back 2 years ago or even 1 year ago. The code that we used to write 1 year ago, it's completely different from the code that we will write today if we're going to start a brand new project right now. So I want to take you along with me on this journey so we can explore everything that has changed and all the new capabilities that are still to come. So who's this course for? Well, if you are new to Angular, or if you are used to classic versions of Angular or the more legacy versions, and you wanna learn everything about the new capabilities, or if you're also coming from other UI frameworks or libraries, you're also welcome. As long as you want to learn Angular, everybody is welcome. So what are we going to cover in this playlist? We're gonna start with the basic building blocks, components, standalone, of course, templates, directives, signals, the built-in control flow at if, for, and switch, the routing with functional guards as well, so we can add a little bit of security to our routes and different pages. We're also going to cover forms and validations depending when we're going to publish the form content. We will also check out the form signals. We're also going to cover some performance features such as deferrable views, modern testing with VTest. This is a big shift. We're going to talk about that. And also migrating older versions of Angular to the most recent ones, and much more. The biggest shift, of course, is all about signals. Angular started its renaissance by introducing the standalone components and getting rid of the ng modules. And slowly, Angular is also getting rid of RxJS, which was also a big learning curve for anybody that was trying to learn Angular and has been introducing signals as a new way to manage the UI state, which is great, and it simplifies a lot of things for us. And the most recent change is the introduction of VTest as the default test runner. Now, this is not just a tooling change for testing, it also changes the way that we have to think about tests also by incorporating all the Angular best practices according to the styling guide. And we're gonna cover everything. You're gonna find out why VTest is a little bit different than using Karma and Jasmine, which was the previous default tooling, or even if you prefer to use Jest. We're gonna cover all these topics and much more. Let me know in the comments if there is anything in specific that you'd like me to cover. I'll be happy to take on any requests as I am recording this course, and I hope to see you on my next video.